South Africa is facing an energy crisis. Its burgeoning population is making demand for energy soar. And yet, in a country of more than 50 million people, some 8 million have no access to electricity. By 2030, the South African government wants that dramatically changed. With 90% of the country's power still generated by coal, South Africa is looking for a cleaner energy source. And the answer could be just inland from Cape Town, in the vast area of the Karoo. Scientists believe that beneath this semi-arid land lies a huge reservoir of shale gas. But opinion is divided on whether that gas should ever be touched.
The Karoo was made over millions of years, and you can mess it up in one day.
If it gets polluted, what happens then?
Those who don't have anything, they want this project so much.
Janice Munyan from Shell's Cape Town headquarters is exploring the prospect of drilling for natural gas in the Karoo.
We're going to have a serious problem in the future if we do not find alternative ways of creating energy. And if shale gas is there and it's accessible and it's commercially viable to actually extract, it's definitely something that could be a game changer in South Africa.
The only way to access the gas is through hydraulic fracturing, or fracking, an advanced drilling technique that extracts gas that's trapped between different layers of rock. A mix of water, sand, and about 1% of chemicals is pumped through the well, fracturing the rock and releasing the gas. Shale gas could supply much of South Africa's clean energy needs for decades to come. But the proposals are proving highly controversial.
Fracking no! Fracking never!
The South African government recently lifted a moratorium on applications to frack. Now Shell and three other companies have applied for licenses to explore for the gas. There is widespread fear that drilling could contaminate water supplies. The Karoo's farming community is particularly concerned.
How are you?
I'm well, thanks. Yourself?
My son, Eric.
Yeah. Okay. Hello, Isaac.
Hello.
A dedicated Shell team has come to the Karoo to better inform the locals and try to allay concerns.
And then meet Charmaine.
Hello.
And we see Le.
Three of the team grew up in the area, so know it well.
We'll be spending most of the time. She's the community liaison officer based here. And
like other farmers, Isaac Krobela is dependent on underground water for both his farming and domestic needs.
We're extremely reliant on our underwater aquifers. Without that, we will be dead. It's a semi-desert area, and it's really not farmable at all if we don't have underwater reservoirs to tap from.
For Isaac, clean water is vital. Being without it is not something he wants to risk.
If our water gets polluted, I mean, how long can animals survive without water?
You are worried about disaster situations. We are forced, actually, to have those disaster management plans in place even before the processes that would assist in the event of any mishap. And maybe at a later stage, we could talk again as to whether concerns were addressed and what is there that still needs to be addressed.
South Africa needs all the sources of energy. The shale gas is part of that.
It produces much less emissions than, for example, coal would.
Karoo-born Vuyisile Zanani wants the local communities to understand the positive social benefits Shell could bring.
Before we actually come to this area, we do what is known as social scanning, understanding the area, as it is right now before we can even do anything in this area. We're looking at issues of education resources, health resources, sicknesses in this area, employment, unemployment, population dynamics, and all of that.
These outreach meetings at remote farms take time, but they are having a positive effect. The team has explained that the gas is trapped far below the water table in shale beds 2 kilometers down. Isaac's water supply should not be affected in any way.
I was much more concerned and much more worried about it when I heard it first. As time has gone on and we learned more about it, I mean, I'm still not at ease, but I feel, you know, you've got some information and that's better.
The Shell team moves on to visit more farmers. Winning public opinion is an enormous task for them.
The main challenge is the fear of unknown, and as well, they are concerned about the contamination of the water aquifer, and as well, you look at the chemicals which will be used for the project.
It's about developing the relationships and getting out to the landowners, to the farmers, to the people who are affected, the employed, the unemployed, and talking and talking and talking. So can we achieve it all in a couple of months? Absolutely not. It's going to take quite a lot more.
The team also holds public meetings to ensure local communities are kept updated and to give them a chance to air their views.
If there's an earthquake and up in Ugrabis there's regular small earthquakes, but what will those do to the integrity of the shell the cement casing?
The standard protocol is shutdown operation. This is standard across Shell globally. Shutdown operation tests the integrity of the well. If you cannot ensure that the well integrity is 100% the way you designed it to be, then you start mechanisms to then rectify that.
We like to mitigate against all those potential risks and have safety plans in place. We won't walk away from the responsibility.
Despite the team's assurances, at any social gathering, fracking remains a hot topic.
I have been to, you know, some of the public meetings, and, you know, obviously they've got their best spin doctors there. But, you know, when the geologists have actually been asked the critical question, can you assure us that it's 100% safe, you know, they say no.
That is the main worry, and that life is going to change, you know, for us in the Karoo. But, you know, it's been a long-standing way of life.
For these farmers, the issue is personal. Billions of rand would be injected into the economy, creating thousands of jobs. But finance is not these farmers' main concern.
My concern is my children. Did I mess up their future, or did I protect the future?
Because we have got such a wonderful way of life here, money is important, but it's not the most important thing to us.
But to many in the Karoo, the view on fracking is markedly different. The majority of the population here is poor. Some work as farm labourers, but most live in urban townships where unemployment is as high as 80%. Community leaders are excited about the economic investment Shell would bring.
We need the injection that would come. We need, because Shell is not only coming with the money, but they're bringing in a lot of the other expertise, and all of that can work to our advantage. From listening to communities, those who don't have anything, they want this project so much.
No. Mnandi kole. Yende mal ni kusho vuleke ni misebenzi yibona ziyobona sikhakhe sizinto zabantu nonjani bona
inganciphisa ewe i-crime rate and inika abantu bethu jobs because abantu bethu bayasuffarisha ngenxa yento yongabikho komsebenzi
because asahambi ngaloo ngqondo kuba sihamba ngobumhlophe nobumnyama because they come to help us because nathi sixakekile apha.
We can have young people skilled and later taking on learnerships and internships with Shell on this project and also to develop a skills level.
If Shell is granted a license to explore for gas in the Karoo, operations won't begin until rigorous environmental assessments are complete. It's a long process. Ongoing dialogue with local communities will be crucial. Generating South Africa's electricity using gas would emit half the amount of carbon dioxide than generating it with coal. And Shell's safety record on extracting shale gas is good. It encases its drill pipes securely and makes every effort to ensure water contamination does not occur.
We need to be cautious and we need to apply those vigorous safety principles to ensure that we can maintain that track record. And there isn't a reason why we shouldn't maintain that track record going forward.
Questions about safety far outnumber any other asked of Shell's team in the Karoo. For Claude Vanker, a strong safety record is vital.
Shell is really pedantic about the safety. If Shell was not concerned about safety, I was not going to take this role at all.
In Africa, people talk about a big change, a big job, and how do you achieve it? This is a marathon, it's not a sprint.
A lot of ground has been covered, and the team heads for home. But this is a journey which has a long way to run. It requires a great deal of energy. In the end, that's exactly what they hope it will bring.